Do you have a complex wire device and you want to use it properly and efficient? Stay tuned and watch this video. What is in the box? Before we start, we first take a look at what do we have in the box. For an SP4, we have a device. We have some manuals. In those manuals, we also have nice electrode placement sheet, but I recommend to download the Compax app and select your device, in this case an SP4, and you can find all the electrode placements in your telephone. Then we have four cables. We call that a snap. It's a snap connection to cables, and we have one MI sensor cable. We have of course the battery, the charger, and standard in the box, we have four bags of electrodes. We have two bags of small electrodes, and there are four of those in each bag. We have two bags of big electrodes, and you have two of them in each bag. And we have a travel pouch, and with the travel pouch, you can put everything in there, and you can take it away on your trip or your journey. Install a Compax wire device. Before we start using the device, let's install it first. I left out some products from the box because they are not necessary for installing the device. And to start, we put in the battery first. So we open the Compax on the back side. Here you have the battery, there's a clip, and that clip perfectly fits here. So you put it in and the battery is in. If you use Compax regularly, let the battery stay in the device. If you don't use Compax for a long time, then put the battery out and lay it beside your Compax where you store it, but don't put the battery in the machine and lay it away for a long time. That will wear down your battery, and then you probably need a new battery when you start using the Compax after a long time again. Yeah, so if you want to charge the Compax, here on the first hole of the connections, you can plug it in and you directly see that the time of the charging and how full the battery is. If the charger plug is in there, there is a safety in the Compax. You cannot put in a cable. It's impossible because there is a safety where you cannot stimulate and connect on the 220 at the same time. So if I put out this cable, then you will see I can put in the cable again. And now I cannot charge it. I cannot pull the charger cable, put the charger cable in there. So that's a safety. If you have fully charged your Compax and it takes around 4 or 4.5 hours, then you can use the Compax for about 8 training sessions or recovery sessions, full training or recovery sessions. So charge it fully and you can maybe use it for a whole week. The Compax cables. We have four Compax cables with colors like blue, green, yellow and red, and they are corresponding to the blue, green, yellow and red button. You can also put them other way around because it fits all, but it's better to put it on the related color. It's easier for you when you manage your intensity level later on. You have one MI sensor cable. I recommend not to use the MI sensor for the first time. I go in detail in the next video about what MI sensor or the MI functions are, but basically for now, you need to know when you put in the MI sensor cable, you can put it on every hole here, not the first one because the first one is for the charging. But if you put it in and you connect your device and you start a program, then he automatically gives an intensity itself because he wants to find the optimum intensity level. That can be a little bit inconvenient or maybe not so nice to feel. So the MI sensor, I always say, don't use it the first time, build your experience first with the normal cables, and when you know what you can expect of feeling with when you're using compacts, then you use the MI sensor cable.
Connecting electrodes and button explanation.
So I put in some cables for example, when I start to use compacts. Those electrodes, I stick those electrodes on my muscle. You can watch in the compacts app how to do that. And then you can plug it on. You have two ends on one cable. It doesn't matter which goes up or down or which way to go. So put it on one or two. It can be go this one on that one and that one on this one. It doesn't matter. So let's see, very easy. So I click on one muscle group. I click on the second muscle group. Then I will switch on the device. But before I switch it on, I will explain you the buttons on the machine.
Press the on button to switch on the device or go back in the menu. Press the I button for your favorite programs or to fix channels. The plus and minus button is for the intensity level, scrolling up and down, and select a program. The settings of a wired device. When you press and hold the on button, you come into the settings. With the red button, you can adjust the light of the screen in on, off, or automatic. With the yellow button, you can adjust the volume of the device. With the green button, you can adjust the contrast of the screen. With the blue button, you can scroll up and down in the menu. Here you can see if you need to charge your battery. Press on to go back. Selecting programs. Press the on button to enter the menu. We will choose conditioning by pressing the plus on the red button to confirm. By pressing the minus on the blue button, we scroll down to endurance. By pressing the plus on the red button, we confirm again. You're entering the cycle selection. Choose cycle 1 to start the program. You start the program in the warm-up. You can see it by those icons. The total duration of this program is 48 minutes. Here you can find the intensity levels corresponding to the channels below. After the warm-up, this arrow and this icon shows you that you're entering the training session. This is the contraction phase and this is the relaxation phase of each cycle. After the training, you switch to the cooldown. You can see it by this arrow and this icon. Releasing the cables.
Now you've done the exercise, so gently release the cables from the electrodes. I always recommend to hold it a little bit close to the connection and then pull and twist. So if you do pull and twist and you pull and twist, then you avoid pulling off those metal things on the electrodes. Some people are pulling it up off like this, but then you will damage your electrodes. So I always recommend to hold your fingers close to the connection and turn and pull. Also try to avoid to do a lot of rounding up your cables tightly, because you don't want to break a cable. And when you break a cable or you make an intern break, then it doesn't work anymore and it gives a failure signal in the machine. So be gentle with your cables and be gentle with your electrodes.
Tips for a compact wire device.
I will give you 6 tips. Tip number 1. So when you don't use compacts anymore for a long time and you storage it in your cupboard or something, then you have to put out the battery. If the battery stays in the machine, it can wear down and it can give a default in the machine when you start using it again. The second tip is when you want to charge your device and you put the charger in the device, you plug it in, you cannot put in the cables. And when the cables are in, you cannot put in the charger. That's a safety. So that's why there is a lock here in the machine which prevents you of adding in both of the cables. The third thing is that Compax has a warranty of 2 years. If you register your device on the Compax website and you fill in your serial number, and that you can find the serial number here on the back side of the device, then you get a 1 year extra warranty.
Go to compax.com, scroll down and select product registration. Fill in your details and serial number for the extended warranty.
3 years or 2 years if you don't register is on the device itself. On the battery and on the cables, it's only 6 months. Tip number four is you can pimp your device with some faceplate stickers. I will give you some examples. Tip five is you can skip through your programs when you're doing a training program. So you can skip the warm-up and you can directly also go to the cool-down. You can do it like this.
When the program starts or is active, press the on button to stop. The program comes in the pause mode and you will see this screen. When you press the plus or minus on the yellow button, you can skip back and forward in the program.
The last tip is that when you press the I button, you're directly in your top 5 programs which you used the last time. So if you want to have a quick start on programs you use often, then use the I button.
When you switch on the machine, you see this screen. Now press the I button and you directly come into your top 5. This is a quick start of starting programs.
With the I button, you can also fix channels by pressing it 1, 2, 3, or 4 times. And then you can lock 1, 2, 3, or 4 cables or channels at the same time. So if you then press up in the plus or the minus, then all 4 or 3 or 2 channels go simultaneously up and down in intensity level.
Press several times on the I button and you see how many channels are locked together. With one button, you can increase all intensity levels.
So I hope you enjoyed the video. Have fun with using Compax and your wire device Compax, and see you next time in a new video.